All right, let's recap one more time some of the things we learned about our cost behavior. Again, our utilities cost had a fixed component, a variable component, and then we assumed there was some inflation, so we've included a column or data for our price index for the period. We also assumed there was a seasonal component, so we included a 0-1 dummy variable, 0 in the months where we don't run our air conditioning, 1 for the months we do run our air conditioning. For our depreciation equipment, it was $10,000 a month until we purchased our new equipment. So it was $10,000 over 0 for the dummy variable for the first period. Once we shifted to $13,000, we included a 1 for our dummy variable. Then finally, we discussed the change in the base wage rate that we were paying our maintenance people. It was $7.50 an hour. With a new contract, we increased it to $8.50 an hour. So over the first part of the period, we had a 0 for the dummy variable, and then in the second part, once the wage rate shifted up, we put a 1. So now let's go ahead and run a multiple regression, including these dummy variables in our price index. One of the things we need to do is we can't have to have the data continuous, so we're going to go ahead and get rid of our month column real quick. So we're going to delete that column. Now we can run our multiple regression. Again, so we're going to go up to Data, Data Analysis. We're going to select Regression, OK. And we are going to want to estimate our total machine cost. And we want to predict our machine cost on the basis of our wage contract, our price index, our new equipment, seasonal trend, number of units. So we'll highlight that data. Our data does have labels, and we're going to put the output right down here on our spreadsheet, right over here. So OK, and poof, we've got it. Let's go ahead and take a look at it. We can see immediately we had a significant improvement in our R square. By cleaning up our data and taking into account some of these trends, we have increased the R square from roughly 52% to 95%. Now, if we want to use our data to predict our cost in the coming month, let's go ahead and think what it is we have. In terms of, we certainly will pick up the intercept. So we've got the 3,476. The wage contract. We are under the new wage contract, so we've got a dummy variable of 1. Our price index, let's assume there's no change in the coming month period. We could pick a 2.7 or something if we thought it was going to go up a little bit, but we'll go with our 2.694. Our new equipment, we do have new equipment, so the dummy variable here is 1. In terms of the seasonal trend, we are still in the winter or fall month, so we've got 0 for our seasonal trend. And if we wanted to predict our cost at, say, 2,500 units, we'll put in 2,500 there. So we've got, in terms of coefficients, 1 times our 1674 for the wage contract. We've got our price index times the coefficient for the price index. We've got 1 times the coefficient for the new equipment. We've got 0 times our seasonal trend, again, because we're not in the summer months. And then finally, we've got 2,500 times the number of our coefficient for the number of units. And we can add up this total cost column, and we would have an expected total cost of roughly $56,000 or $57,000 if we wanted to produce 2,500 units of output. If we were to look at the t-statistics for each one of these coefficients and trying to evaluate how important they are to our model, one thing we do observe: the wage contract, with a very small t-statistic of 0.54, suggests that it's not necessarily that significant. Now, if this was a data set where we didn't know there was a shift in wages, we would perhaps consider excluding it. But since we know that the wages did shift from $750 an hour to $850 an hour, we will certainly include it in our final equation. One of the reasons it has a very low t-statistic is if you think about our total cost up top, the variable component of our maintenance wage is very small in terms of our overall machine-related cost each month. So the